down. When the usher being here, they would hold you. It would take the whole usher board, plus some voluntary ushers, to set you down. And you was in $50,000 worth of debt. And somebody came by, canceled your debt. You wouldn't be able to sit still. So if you can get in your mind that this is a Pentecost season, this is a jubilee, where God said, I'll restore the year.
Trouble upon me and wrath, they hate me. My heart is severely pained within me, and the terrors of death have fallen upon me. Fearfulness and trembling have come upon me, and horror has overwhelmed me. So I said, oh, that I had wings like a dove. I would fly away and be at rest. Indeed, I would wander far off and remain in the wilderness. I would hasten my escape from the windy storm and tempest. Destroy, O Lord, and divide their tongues. For I have seen the violence and strife in the city. Day and night they go around it, in its walls. Iniquity and trouble are also in the midst of it. Destruction in the midst. Oppression and deceit do not depart from its streets. For it is not an enemy who reproaches me, then I can bear it. Nor is it one who hates me, who has exalted himself against me, then I can hide from him. But it was you, a man, my equal, my companion, my acquaintance. We took sweet counsel together and walked to the house of God in the throne. Let death seize them. Let them go down alive into hell, for wickedness is in their dwellings and among them. As for me, I will call upon the God, and the Lord shall save me. The Lord shall save me. And the Lord shall save me.
Not the people.
Representation of Pentecost. Shouts over Pentecost, because to us that's the only feast that we really should be concerned with, Prophet Mills. Because that is the feast that brought about the church, the power, amen. But I just want to impress in our spirit that Pentecost is a feast.
Yeah.
I thought this was interesting.
Many.
He didn't just show one time. By many
infallible
proofs.
My God.
Being seen of them
40
days.
Yes.
Some about 40.
Yes.
And speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God.
Yes.
Somebody shout, that's the government.
Yes.
That's the government of God. And being assembled together. Everybody say location, location, location. It's all about your location. Where are you in the spirit? Location, location, location. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem. Now they always came back to Jerusalem on the feast.
Yes.
Particularly, he commanded him, don't leave.
Because
if you leave, you're going to miss something.
My God.
I got to slow walk this, y'all. If you leave, you're going to miss something.
My God.
But wait.
Wait.
Everybody shout, wait.
Wait.
That's not a popular word. We don't like that. Because I want my stuff now. But he told them, but wait.
Wait.
And watch this. Your waiting is not going to be in vain. Wait what?
For
the promise.
See,
that's why we got to wait, y'all. Because a lot of times we go before the wait is up. But some calls you're on, they say your estimated wait time is 5 minutes.
There it is.
So you were closer, Sister Joshua, than when you first. They say don't hang up.
Right.
Because if you hang up, you'll lose your spot.
Because
sometimes, Sister Saul, we on the call and they tell us we're 5 minutes. But that ain't good enough for us. We're like, you know what? Because 5 minutes seems like 20. There's something about this wait. See, they had to wait. Because what if they decided? I heard Vangel Max, that was an awesome word. Good
amen.
God Almighty.
Yeah.
I've got the power.
Yeah.
But it wasn't until they waited.
Yes,
they didn't get the power before the wait.
Yes,
your wait time.
Stand on it.
Your wait time.
Come on now.
gonna do it.
Come on now.
All God really wanna know from us is how long you gonna wait. And is your promise really worth your wait?
Come on, say it again. I'm trading my sorrows.
I'm trading my sorrows
for the joy of the Lord.
Silk learning? I think we got some folks need to register. He told them wait 49 days plus one. I'm gonna add one. Your estimated wait time. Let me read the scripture accurately. It is not for you to know. Don't you worry about what God's part is.
Right.
Can you just handle your part? How many women here had a baby? You waited 9 months. Did you just get a pampers when the baby was about to show up? No, you shouldn't if you were a good preparer. You prepared stuff. But
what?
I'm not leaving y'all out now. Uh-huh. This is what Jesus said. But ye shall receive what?
After the wait time.
God talking to somebody about waiting today.
Come on.
After the wait time. 10 years ago, after the wait time. Lord, this thing ain't happening quick enough after the wait time. Lord, I'm getting itchy now after the wait time. Lord, I'm getting anxious, but he already told you in his word, be anxious for nothing.
Yes.
But in everything. Supplication, prayer, thanksgiving. It's right. Because him can always beat to kick a 10. Oh, well, maybe not. When I went there, they did. No front row, sir. But you can't curse your crab.
Anyway.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. Whoa. How'd I get there? Well, where Dion at? Well. You fight, rip and roar, try some more of the red and white. You know, oh, y'all don't say that no more. I'm sorry. That was the 80s version of the cheer. But y'all know y'all.
Wow.
See, if you worship while you wait, it'll change your perspective on the way.
Yeah.
See, when they put you on hold and say, your estimated time is 5 minutes, do you know what you could accomplish in 5 minutes?
Yeah.
And if you got speakerphone, you can put it on speaker and you can still hear when they come to the phone. But you could be doing so much in 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Instead of getting mad about your 5 minutes, worship while you wait. When you know you're about to get something, I promise you, wait. Jesus.
No,
Terry means wait. Ye in the city of Jerusalem. Until ye be
endued
with power
from on high. Yes.
Now you can say, I got the power. And then look at the attitude in waiting. Look at the attitude, Dre. You see this? Look at the attitude.
Yes.
And they did what I want everybody to read it. And they worshiped him.
Oh, Mr. Kairos, we are in the time zone of God.
Attitude determines everything.
Yes.
Has anybody ever heard this saying, your attitude determines your altitude. Yes. Look at a thing, or how you conceptualize it in your mind will take you either up or down. But because the disciples left an example for us, they had great joy in the command to wait. Wait is driving people crazy, probably. The wait is driving for trying to anyway. Lord, you promised me something, but I don't see it coming to pass. Well, God said, if you look in my word, I've never let a promise go down. Have you ever seen a promise that God made in the word? A lot of people are saying the Lord said. The Lord said he was going to do this. The Lord said he was going to do that. I challenge you all to line your the Lord said up with the word. You know the Lord like you say you know the Lord. You'll get joy in the wait. Because you'll stop crying over the Lord told me to wait 5 years and realize that in the 5 years is a process. That maybe God wants to develop you. Maybe he wants to equip you. Maybe he wants to give you some more stamina. Because y'all, when we get out here operating, we're going to have strength.
God is going to save us and set us apart because we have to show them that God can still move. Amen. We can show them that God is still moving and God is still blessing and God is still showing favor in the midst of all the trouble and trials and tribulations that the world is going through. We are a testimony. We are a testimony.
A blessed church.
We decree
that this is
a full church.
Souls will be saved.
Sanctified.
Baptized.
And filled
with the Holy Ghost.
They're coming from the north. They're coming from the south.
They're coming from the east.
And they're coming from the west.
We decree
that miracles
shall be performed
in our lives. And it is so.
These people knew the type and shadow. They knew what they were waiting for. Maybe that's the issue. Maybe a lot of us get tired of the wait because we don't know what we wait for. So when somebody tells us to wait, we don't just be like, because number one, I really want to know, is it worth my waiting?
It is.
I'll go ahead. Is it worth me really waiting? Yes, how valuable is it? Come on, y'all. Let's not get deep. Because y'all know, anytime we're doing something, we like, what's in it for me?
Come on now. Make it plain.
Come on. Yes. Eric, the holiest of all of us, what's in it for me?
Come on now.
But you got to keep that under subjection, right? Because it's not all about us. But anytime you're waiting, you like to know what you're waiting for.
Amen.
So maybe that's the key today. Is that a lot of us are waiting, God has told us to wait, but because our relationship with God, maybe we didn't quite hear what he said wait for.
My God.
I knew what they was waiting for. Go ahead.
Verses 16 through 18.
Type of shadow. Go ahead.
And it came to pass on the third day in the morning. That there were thunders and lightnings, and a thick cloud upon the mount, and the voice of the trumpet exceeding loud, so that all the people that was in the camp trembled. And Moses brought forth the people out of the camp to meet with God. And they stood at the nether part of the mount. And Mount Sinai was altogether on a smoke, because the Lord descended upon it in fire. And the smoke thereof ascended as the smoke of a furnace. And the whole mount quaked greatly.
Do that sound like the day of Pentecost to y'all? The Old Testament feast was the time when God, we just saw it, God gave Moses and his people the commandments. And these commandments were to guide them. Come on, y'all, if you stay with me, you'll connect the dots. To guide them. On Mount Sinai was when Moses received the commandments. And the scripture we just read said there was thunder and lightning and tongues of fire. And there was also shaking along with the fire. The power of the Holy Ghost gives us fire.
Yes.
Come on, how many know? We get fire.
Yes.
The power of the Holy Ghost, while y'all getting Leviticus 23, also gives us anointing. Do y'all remember? Anointing is the ability to do something that we couldn't do in the natural. Anointing is the supernatural. Everybody shout supernatural. In this church age we're in now, if I can say it that way, we are dismissing the supernatural.
My God.
Come on, can somebody clap and say, help us, Lord. Because we got to get out of the natural into the supernatural. And supernatural does not look like natural. Supernatural is above and beyond. Supernatural is what?
Above and beyond.
So supernatural goes above my natural ability. That's why he told me, he said, when you receive this power, you're going to be able to lay hands on the sick. And what's going to happen?
Yes, yes.
Key, you're going to be able to do it.
Come on, right.
Because I've given you power.
Yes.
See, I don't want us to get lost on, I've got the power. But what do we have the power to do?
Yes, yes.
We have the power, you do something.
Absolutely.
In Psalms 1, it says, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper.
Yes.
So in the supernatural, you got to just present yourself, your natural,
yes,
and let God put his super to your natural.
Yes.
And there's the supernatural.
Yes.
People are scared of the supernatural, Prophet Raymond.
Yes.
They're scared of the supernatural. You know why? Because supernatural is risky.
Yes.
But if we're moving in the power of the supernatural,
yes,
Holy Ghost, they shall.
Yes.
Come on, I'm trying to get some believers in here.
Yes.
It's good that you got the Holy Ghost. I'm glad you know you got your dance perfected. But do you have the asking God to do stuff that he said, I got the power. Because if he was going to do it all himself, and see, he had to give them the power because he knew he was about to go up. But his work still needed to be spread throughout.
Greater work.
Oh, come on. He said, yeah, greater work shall
he do.
But poor them say, greater works. Oh, y'all, some of y'all scared. Greater works. Y'all can point. Did you see what she did? We ain't used to that. Did you see what she did? That ain't God, because that ain't how we did it. The supernatural is not about how you do it, but it's about how God do it. And when you move in the supernatural, anything can happen. Take the risk. So, if people in the hospital, Elder Hunter, because you got the power,
supernatural.
Stop being scared. Because see, the demons are using the supernatural on the dark side. Why you think we got witchcraft workers? Why you think we got psychic lines? Why you think we got all these Ouija boards? Because they're using the supernatural on the dark. That Jesus shed his blood. Got up on the third day with all power in his hands. Waited 50 days, fill the church with power, true engine time, one in Messiah, and you mean to tell me the psychics don't get all the air time? I don't even want nobody talking to me. If you ain't really ready for the supernatural. You got the power. gospel. Jesus went about preaching the gospel of the kingdom.
Yes, he did.
That's right.
I'm going to say it again. Jesus preached the gospel of the kingdom. And wherever the gospel of the kingdom was preached, poverty couldn't stay around. Sickness couldn't stay around. Death couldn't stay around. That's why they were able to raise dead people. Oh, yeah, we celebrate Pentecost. And we prepare for some miracles. We prepare for some supernatural. We prepare for some unorthodox move of God. We ain't going to put God in a box. But we're going to move in the power. He said, after this, you shall receive power. After your wait time is up, you're going to receive some power. And then I'm going to send you out. God ain't saying nothing about it. I'm going to send you out. You are going to be authorized. You got authority in my name. You got power in the Holy Spirit. If somebody comes say their head is hurting, say by the authority and the power vested in me. I speak to headache. Try up. Come on, come on, y'all. See, this ain't a rim for low self-esteem. This ain't a rim for inadequacy. This ain't a... We got to mobilize in this. We got to wait until we know we're confident in the God in us. Because, see, the risk is because we're still in us. The risk is because I don't know how to operate. I don't. But the Holy Ghost will teach you all things. The Holy Ghost is accurate. The Holy Ghost don't make mistakes. So when you put a demand on the power, the Holy Ghost will always produce. Believe y'all. No saints in this feast time should be saved. Because you ought to realize that some cancellation is about to happen in your life. Some cancellation of generational curses. Some cancellation of sicknesses in your body. Some cancellation of physical debt and spiritual debt. Some cancellation is about to happen. God said, I'm about to cancel some appointments. I'm about to cancel some demonic assignments. I'm about to cancel some curses and hex, the witches and warlocks. I'm about to cancel them. You don't have to be afraid. And the young boy, I'm all over the Bible. Perfect, we'll get there, baby. Leviticus. And I wanted to show y'all where the 50 came from. Because Pentecost also means 50. And 50 means Jubilee. Pentecost was also a summer harvest. Pentecost. Are we about to go into summer? We already there? When summer came in? Oh, I thought it was June 20. Oh, you talking about in the spirit. Okay. Well, on God's calendar, we are. On this Roman Gregorian calendar, we still waiting for summer. But Pentecost is a feast, a summer feast. That after they had gleaned, they brought their sheaves together. Come on, and they lifted and they waved them to the Lord. But Pentecost was also a harvest time and a revelation time. Pentecost was a time where